Welcome to Decoded by Christina. Today I'll be talking about how to create a sticky footer using CSS Grid. Let's get started. Most web pages have the same basic layout: a header, some content in the middle, and a footer at the bottom. If you don't have enough content to fill the entire page, the footer will just hover underneath the last content block. To keep the footer at the bottom of the page, even when the content is short, we can create what is commonly called a sticky footer. In most cases, it's not recommended to set a fixed height for the page layout elements because you want the content to be flexible. Instead, we can use Grid to set a relative height value that will automatically expand or contract based on the user's browser viewport size. Tools like CodePen are designed for testing smaller code snippets, so the HTML and body tags that are required when creating HTML pages don't need to be added to the CodePen HTML panel. They're already included in the back end of the tool. This is what the full HTML markup looks like with the HTML and body tags included. When using Grid, start by identifying the parent element that contains the items you want to apply the grid styles to. In this case, we want to expand the main content area, so the parent element is body. Even though we can't see the body tag in the HTML panel, it's included in the tool, so we can still use body as a selector and apply CSS styles to it, which I'll add to the CSS panel. Then use the display property with a value of grid to define body as the grid container, making the header, main, and footer elements all grid items. We won't see any immediate changes yet, but the grid layout has been initialized. Before adjusting the size of the grid items, let's look at the body element, which represents the visible area in the browser viewport. Usually it'll be the whole browser window minus the menu bar, but in CodePen, the viewport is the size of the output window. The body contains all the page content, and by default, it's only as tall as its content. I'll add a border to the body element to demonstrate. To align the footer to the bottom of the page, the body element must also expand to the full height of the viewport, regardless of the amount of content. This can be achieved by setting the height for the body element. The HTML element is often included as well, since it wraps the body element. The height property should be used with a relative unit such as 100% to fill the entire page. 100VH can also be used. VH is a newer unit that represents the viewport height. Both options achieve the same results. Now the body element fills the entire page. And by default, the height of the grid items will also automatically adjust to fill the remaining space. However, we want the header and footer to match their content height, and just the main element to fill the remaining space, since this is where the majority of page content goes. The height of the grid items can be defined using the grid template rows property. We have three items that we want to size, so we can use three values: auto, 1FR, auto. This means that the header and footer will automatically adjust their height based on their content. The second value, 1FR, sets the height of the second grid item, which is the main element. The FR unit represents a fraction of the available space in the grid container. Setting the value to 1FR means filling up 100% of the remaining space. And that's it! You now have a sticky footer. The main area will always take up the remaining space, regardless of the amount of content. This means the footer will always remain at the bottom of the page. I also have a video using Flexbox to create the sticky footer. The link is in the description below. Both techniques have their own advantages, and which one you choose may depend on the rest of your page's layout. For example, if you're already using Flexbox for other effects, then use the Flexbox technique. When writing CSS, it's good to understand how different techniques work so you can decide which option is best for the task at hand. Thanks for tuning into this edition of Decoded by Christina. See you next time. Bye!